Can we truly believe everything we see? Throughout human evolution, we've relied on our sight more than any other sense to understand our surroundings and ultimately inform decisions that ensure our survival. This is reflected by how central sight is to our entire concept of knowledge, understanding, and truth. We talk about shedding light on a topic. When we understand someone, we see what they're saying. But what happens when our sight becomes unreliable? When seeing is no longer believing? The huge advances in CGI over recent decades have normalized the idea of being visually deceived. The suspension of disbelief in seeing Spider-Man swing from skyscrapers or spaceships descend from the clouds is all part of the movie-going experience. Which is fine, because most of these are fantastical showpieces not intended to actually fool us. And even when the visual trickery is more subtle, we either accept it as a storytelling tool or we don't even notice. But while CGI's heightened believability is certainly impressive, it could also turn out to be problematic. The past few years have seen the rise of deepfakes, manipulated videos in which one person's likeness is replaced with another's. The incredibly realistic nature of these videos means that they can be startlingly believable, and they've already been at the center of some controversy, with fabricated videos of politicians and celebrities ruffling more than a few feathers. While deepfakes do utilize some of the same sophisticated CGI techniques used in Hollywood movies, it's important to note that they also differ from them in at least one crucial way. While assembling each CGI shot in a blockbuster can take weeks, sometimes months, of painstaking work by a large team, deepfakes can be created by one person, sometimes in days or even hours. And this is possible because of the process used to create them, which is known as deep learning. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning, which is a subset of artificial intelligence. Put simply, it works by learning in a similar way to the human brain, taking in huge amounts of data and teaching itself to recognize patterns within it. For example, if you show a deep learning algorithm a few thousand pictures of bananas, eventually it will learn that anything curved in yellow could be a banana. The more pictures it has access to, the wider its understanding of what constitutes a banana, and the more accurately it will recognize them. Systems like this aren't perfect, but they're improving all the time, and crucially, they're doing so on their own. That's kind of the whole point. They're designed to constantly critique their own work, detecting flaws to improve their techniques. Even though this technology sounds pretty cutting edge, it's already being widely used in self-driving cars, Google Translate, image sorting, and here's the important one, facial recognition. In the case of deepfakes, the algorithm is given as many examples of the same face as possible, with varying angles, lighting, and expressions, and it uses this information to build an understanding of the features of that face. It then combines this information with CG technology to insert the new face on top of the existing one, either recreating the original expressions and lip movements or creating new ones based on user input. And when you combine these video techniques with similar audio processes or recordings made by voice artists, it becomes possible to insert actors into films they were never in, or put any words in the mouth of any public figure. While this technology has made a home for itself in a surprising range of positive contexts, it's hard not to be unnerved by the negative implications of its misuse. A technology which could so easily and effectively mislead could undermine the basic principles of objective truth that we take for granted, with potential ramifications far beyond our current understanding. As such, the last few years have seen the passing of various articles of deepfake-related legislation and a huge amount of discussion about deepfake detection techniques. But the ethical and legal considerations of such a new technology will take a while to be fully defined. And improved detection techniques come with a brand new headache of their own, because part of the way deepfakes work is to constantly compare their output to a detection system, which means that better detection techniques will only make deepfakes harder to detect. There's no roadmap for what comes next, and it's natural that that's a little scary. But in a way, not being able to take for granted that seeing is believing might have the capacity to teach us a valuable lesson, one which couldn't be more relevant to our times. In the age of fake news, the ability to think critically is taking on a new importance. And as deepfakes become more sophisticated and the opportunity for their misuse grows, being able to contextualize information and verify the reliability of where it comes from are going to become essential life skills, more than ever before.